A leader of the Ehu Matau land occupation says while there's no resolution yet, protesters are still winning as there are no police or houses on the land. Whānau and supporters gathered for a karakia to mark a year since police sought to evict protesters who were living on the disputed land owned by Fletcher Building. Mariana Johnson has more.
It was a much different scene at Ehu Matau this morning, as occupation co-leader Kiani Matata Sipu explains.
We've been able to see the height of the reclamation where police came in and, you know, in military formation, shoulder to shoulder, too deep, and the kind of really mamai feelings of that. And today we are here on the whenua with no police presence, no fences up, no houses being built, and everyone's feeling quite positive.
Exactly a year ago to this day, police accompanied Te Kawaroa Maki chairperson Te Wari Natauwa and Māori wardens onto the land at Ehu Matau to serve the roughly 20 protesters living there with an eviction notice. Tensions escalated when the sole protesters refused to leave, and there was a standoff with police who formed a line at the end of Ehu Matau Quarry Road. One wahine holding a baby asked police what right they had to block the road.
You closed the road. I don't want to argue. I'm stating facts that I felt unsafe amongst you peacekeepers because you haven't stated why you closed our road in the first place. Yet you allow these big trucks to go past us. Carl, not today.
Later that day, Pania Newton put out the call for people to join them on the land to stop Fletcher's from starting construction. And she made it clear she wasn't going anywhere.
I've been asked how far will I go in this kaupapa, and I say, or I jokingly would say that I would die for this whenua, and by that I mean I will sacrifice everything. I've sacrificed my career, I've sacrificed time with my whānau and my friends, because I know how important my tūranga waiwai and to protect that is for the generations that are yet to come.
Within days, 300 people had turned up to stand on the front line, many bringing their tents and setting up camp on the land. The Prime Minister then stepped in to call for a halt to construction. Thousands continued to flock to the land in the following weeks to support the occupiers with a festival-like environment. But 2 weeks later, the peaceful occupation came to a head when dozens of police went out to the site at night, with protest leader Pania Newton alleging she was pushed by a police officer, a claim that was rejected by police. Around the same time, the Kingitanga offered to bring all parties together to get the matter resolved. They raised their flag and said it would stay there until a resolution was reached. Repeatedly throughout the occupation, Pania Newton has called on the Prime Minister to visit the whenua. But with the Prime Minister ruling out visiting the land in the near future, on August the 22nd, Newton took matters into her own hands.
And we are walking to invite Jacinda Ardern to our whenua. It's incumbent on her to come to Ehu Matau and walk amongst our whenua and her people so she can experience the same feelings that we experience every day.
She led a four-hour hikoi in the wind and rain to Jacinda Ardern's Mount Albert office to deliver a petition signed by more than 20,000 people. In January this year, the Kingitanga returned to the whenua to take their flag down, raising anticipation levels that the land dispute was finally over. However, spokesperson for the King, Ruku Moana Schaffhausen, said the Kingitanga had done their job and passed the rākau back to the government.
There's been a lot of frustration on behalf of the King for the delays that have occurred. But again, our objective was to represent the views of Mana Whenua, to have the whenua returned. And we are confident that that message has been heard. It's taken longer than we believe is necessary. But we have, as I said, we believe there is a pathway to a positive resolution. We are confident that a resolution will be reached before Waitangi. Yes.
But Waitangi Day has been and gone, and a year on from the eviction notice being served, the government remain tight-lipped as to what a deal may look like and when it will be finalised. RNZ reported in June that the land may be acquired under the Housing Act, but leaders of the occupation movement say they're unlikely to accept any deal that requires houses to be built on the whenua. Minister for Finance Grant Robertson says he's still working to find a resolution that respects Crown, Mana Whenua and Fletcher's. RNZ understands that that is unlikely to be finalised before the election. Mo te hōtaka o te ahiahi, ko Mirjana Johnson DNA.